Bonjour les enfants, bonjour tout le monde, c'est Madame Dale. Alors aujourd'hui, nous allons parler de la nourriture et les boissons. We are going to do a quiz. So in your books, when you've written the date, of course, when you've written la nourriture et les boissons, and underneath quiz, what we'd like you to do is on the left-hand side in a margin. On the left-hand side in your book, write the number from 1 to 11 because they are going to be 11 questions. So I'm going to read them aloud, and what we'd like you to do is to tick the answer A or B, or you don't have to write the full word. Okay, so there will be, for example, 1A, for example, or 2B, etc., etc. I'm sure you get me there. Okay, so let's just start our quiz. Listen carefully. Number one, le mot fromage est A, cheese, B, cake. Okay, so in your book, you would have written the number one, so you choose next to it to write A or B, your choice. Number two. Lequel des mots suivants est un fruit? Which following word is a fruit? A, la pomme, B, le poulet, C, l'eau, or D, le lait? Next to your number two, you write either A, B, C, or D. Number three. C'est quoi? So what is a mushroom? A. Du beurre. B. De la crème. C. Un champignon. Or D. Une citrouille. Next to number three, you write A, B, C or D. Trouve l'intrus. Now there is an odd one out. Which one could it be? A, le poulet, or could it be B, le jambon, C, le steak, or D, le poisson? What do you think? Next to you, number four, you write one letter of your choice, A, B, C, or D. Number five, okay, c'est quoi? What is a duck in French? A, un canard, B, une vache, C, un cochon, or D, du thon. Okay, next to number five, you choose a letter, A, B, C, or D. Lequel a des bulles? Which one is sparkling? A, le coca, B, l'eau, or C, le jus d'orange. Which one is fizzy? A, B or C? Number seven. Quelle est l'orthographe correcte? Which one is a correct spelling? Orthographe is spelling. A, les œufs. B, les yeux. C, les yeux. To number seven, you write A, B or C. Number eight. Which one is a vegetable? A, le poulet. B, le coca. C'est la carotte. Oh, this one's tough. Number nine. Oh, this one is very, very tricky. Relis les photos aux mots. So, can you match a picture to the word? So, do we have any cheese connoisseur? So, we have le gruyère, la vache qui rit. In brackets, it means a laughing cow. Le roquefort ou le camembert? Have a go. Can you match each number to the letter? Number 10. Bon appétit signifie. Bon appétit means A. Time to go to bed. B. Enjoy your meal. C. It's getting late. So next to number 10, you choose your letter A, B, or C. And finally, pour Noël, les Français mangent. For Christmas, French people tend to eat. A. Un gâteau aux noisettes. B. Une bûche de Noël. Ou C. De la glace au chocolat. What do you think? Okay, children, let's have a look at the answers together. Okay, so number one, A, is cheese. Cheese et le fromage, indeed. Number two, the fruit is la pomme. A, la pomme is apple. Number three, C, which is un champignon, which is mushroom. Number four, D, le poisson is the odd one out. All the others were different types of meat. Le poisson is fish. Number five, A, un canard. Un canard is a duck. Number six is A, le coca. This is the only fizzy drink. Number seven, A, les œufs. Now this is a correct spelling. O-E-U-F-S for eggs. Okay. However, in French, the O and E should be together, blended together when you write the word down. Number eight, C, carotte. Carotte, which is the only vegetable. Now, carotte is a very similar word to English, isn't it? However, the spelling is different. Okay, number nine. Oh, let's match the different type of cheeses. Number two is a gruyère. The gruyère. The yellow cheese with holes in it. Now, the gruyère is equivalent of the cheddar. People, French people cook a lot with it when they make the pasta bake, for example, they will use Gruyère. When they make a pizza, for example, they will use Gruyère, and so on. La vache qui rit means word by word the laughing cow. It's like a sort of a spread cheese in a little shape of a triangle. Now, they do sell it here. You can find it in England. Now, number three is a roquefort. Le roquefort is a blue and creamy white cheese, very tasty, very strong in flavor. Number one is a camembert, which is another really traditional cheese in France. A little bit like the brie, but a little bit stronger. Okay, now let's move on to number 10. Number 10 is bon appétit, means enjoy your meal, which is B. And finally, number 11 is B, which is la bûche de Noël. Can you remember, bûche de Noël is a chocolate log, isn't it? Christmas, the Christmas traditional fruit cake that we have in England doesn't exist. French people would have a bûche de Noël, which a log is a symbol. Bûche means log, and a log is supposed to be a symbol of good luck and eternity. Okay, children, what is your score? Can you write it down in your book? Right, la classe se termine, les enfants. À la semaine prochaine. À bientôt.